Welcome to CoinMarketCap. If you notice, this is not a part of Binance. This is a separate website called CoinMarketCap.com. And why I'm here is that, if you remember from our previous video, we have already deposited cryptos to our account, right? So now what we have to do is that we need to understand and identify the best cryptocurrency to buy at the moment, because if you are to buy cryptocurrencies, there can be two different reasons and purposes. The first purpose is that you are going to buy cryptocurrencies and you are going to hold it for a, let's say, 5 to 10 years, because you are not going to trade. You are going to buy and keep it as it is in the wallet and hold it and look how it grows. And in case if you see some downfall continuously, you will be able to understand through this website, CoinMarketCap, and quickly transfer those downward coins. You sell it and buy some other improving or having a higher demand coin by the time you start investing. So investing and holding is about keeping your cryptocurrencies, buying and keeping your cryptocurrencies for more than 1 year until you get a good return out of it. And the second thing what you will be doing is, what you can do is the trading. You buy today, let's say you buy let's say from this example, you are going to buy one ADA coin, Cardano, for a price of 1.20. And then when the price rise for, let's say, $2, and you are going to sell it, and then you are creating a profit out of it. And again, you are reinvesting that profit into another coin or for the same, the cryptocurrency. So that is how the trading happens. But wait for the moment, we will be discussing more in detail about how we can do the trading in Binance. Now I am here, as I said to you before, we have deposited funds and you need to understand the best cryptocurrency to invest, hold, or for trading, so you can make a profit out of it. So this website helps you to understand the ranking. Here, if you notice, there are a lot of cryptocurrencies, right? Starting from Bitcoin, Ethereum, Cardano, ADA, Binance Coin, USDT, Polkadot, XRP. Likewise, there are many number of cryptocurrencies as of now. If I were to tell you the number of cryptocurrencies, you can see here 8,657 cryptocurrencies. Let me click on that and we'll have a just look the cryptocurrencies that is available. I'm sure most of you must have heard about Bitcoin, Ethereum, Cardano, Bitcoin Cash and XRP, all these. That there are a lot other cryptocurrencies available in the marketplace which are not much famous right now. So this is to give you all an idea how much of cryptocurrency is available in the market. You can have a look by going into this website, CoinMarketCap, and then you click on the cryptocurrency, then you will be redirected to the total cryptocurrencies available at the moment by the time you visit this website. All right. Now, I'll go back to the top 100 cryptocurrencies. Now, my purpose is to identify the best cryptocurrency to invest, to invest my funds that are deposited in my wallet right now. If you are to buy a Bitcoin, BTC, the current price, 47,839,000, let's say. This is highly volatile. This can increase, this can decrease, and it can fluctuate any second of the day. So this is more of famous, and this cryptocurrency is in its maturity. Bitcoin, we also say based on the history, if we look into the history of this coin, the founder is the Satoshi Nakamoto, and this is what more popular among the crypto world when it comes to the Bitcoin. So if I talk about the history of Bitcoin, it started in somewhere around 2009-2010 and started with the initial listing price of 0.08, and now 10 years since then, now we are in 2021 and see the price. That imagine if you would have bought one cryptocurrencies in 2010, what is the value of that today? It's going to be somewhere around 47,000, or it can even be 50,000, because it's highly volatile. Just before a week ago, it reached to 55,000, but by the time you watch, the prices might have reached maybe say 60,000-70,000. That could be. So this is all about understanding what are the cryptocurrencies available. So what you can understand from this website, now say I want to study more about Bitcoin, I just click on the coin, and you can see, what you can see here is that the Bitcoin price right now, the current price, and what is the change in percentage, whether it is a positive or whether it is a negative. And you also can see within the last 24 hours, what is the lowest price it went to? 40,390, and also highest price it reached to 50,000. So within 24 hours of time, this crypto, which is called the Bitcoin, is trading in between these two values, the lowest and at the highest value. All right. And this cryptocurrency is having a market capitalization. Now, market capitalization of how much? It's a large figure, right? And what is market capitalization? You can simply understand everything through this website, every detail about this cryptocurrency, which is Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrencies, like how I came for this one. It is basically the market cap is the current price into the circulating supply. That means how much of supply is currently circulated within the people like us, how much people have already bought this cryptocurrency into the current price, is called the market capitalization. Or you can understand through this as well, the total market value of a cryptocurrency circulating supply, it is analogous to the free float capitalization in the stock market. This gives you the understanding as to how much the market capitalization, or it covers from the market from the means of Bitcoin. And also likewise, you can see a lot of details here, fully diluted market cap and the volume, how much volume traded within 24 hours of time, a measure of how much a cryptocurrency was traded in the last 24 hours. So this much of amount Bitcoin traded in last 24 hours, and the circulating supply. Also, you can see maximum supply that it can reach is 21 million, and it already reached 18 million. There's a very like around 3 million is left, 89% is completed. So that is why there can be high demand, because the supply is limited. Okay, so how do you define this circulating supply? It is the amount of coins that are circulating in the market and are in public hands, like people like you and me, and it is analogous to the flow in shares in the stock market. So now you have a very basic understanding how you can have a understanding about a cryptocurrencies, whether to invest or not. How I say whether to invest or not, because this is very crucial. How much is the maximum supply? Is 21 million, and the total supply as of now, it's already reached for 18 million. So there's another, how much? 11% is left. So there will be a high demand going forward based on the circulating supply. After that, there has to be new miners to mine these bitcoins, and only it will come into the supply. So that is how the demand will be created for Bitcoin going forward. And a very easy thing how you can predict the history by looking into the history and the current prices, and how you can have a prediction to future as to what you need to invest, or whether you need to invest in Bitcoin or not. Now, this is the all-time growth of Bitcoin. Now, if you notice here, so I would say this from this point, 2013, August 21st, the price went for $120, right? By today, it reached for around 47,000 wided. By looking into this overall, all time, what you can see is the slope upwards, right? It's increasing day by day. There are some kind of the fluctuation. It goes down to the minimum, but still then the overall it's going up. So there's still chance the Bitcoin can reach to another unpredictable level. So it is better. Sometimes we might think now the Bitcoin is at its maturity, but I'm not sure. By the time you watch this video, it might have reached to maybe 100,000. I don't know. That is possible, because that is why we call high risk, high return and highly volatile market this cryptocurrencies. So this is how you can have a very clear view about the currency. And also another thing that we need to understand about this cryptocurrency is that what could be the future demand. Now when I say future demand, how this future demand is created for these cryptocurrencies. Imagine a company which is more famous, let's say Tesla. Few weeks ago, Elon Musk tweeted that he invested $1.5 billion on Bitcoin. And he is going to enable cryptocurrencies as a mode of payment to buy his Tesla cars. Likewise, there are a few other companies like Starbucks and some other companies are planning and have already adopted cryptocurrency payments. They have enabled it. So because of that situation in place, there's a huge demand that if this Bitcoins or the cryptos become a normal day-to-day payment method like PayPal or like the Visa, like that, then there will be a huge demand for these cryptocurrencies. So don't waste your time, invest and keep, you will never regret. So that is something I could say, because being in this trade, and there's high possibility that we can more profit out of it in future, and there will be more organizations, large organizations currently planning and currently putting up strategies to deal with this Bitcoin and trying to make these cryptocurrencies into their mode of payments, and therefore people will be able to make Bitcoin payments to buy goods and services. All good. Now we will go back again to the market, the coin market cap. And this will be the initial screen. And what I did not speak about here is the Bitcoin dominance. As of today, 66.1% Bitcoin is dominating the market. Likewise, ETH, Ethereum, 12.7%, they have captured the total crypto market. So they are like the giants, first and second. And there are some other coins trying to come up. Now, if you feel like looking into this Bitcoin, yeah, it's a positive. The green color indicates it's positive right now. There can be improvement compared to the last 7 days. And the red color indicates a downturn Ethereum is having a downturn and then it can again increase. But these are a bit of expensive right now. As I said before, based on the situation that you watched this video, and there are some cryptocurrencies like Cardano, ADA, if you notice, $1.2, right? And increase in percentage is 29%. That's a significant value. Imagine this crypto you're investing $100, and there you will get 100 ADA of this crypto. And in 2025 or 2030, this can reach to another better level. So how you can do that is, now you here you can see 24 hours. I am going to see within 24 hours what is the most increased crypto. EWT, Energy Web Token. Within this 24 hours, this is the most increased cryptocurrency. Likewise, there are other cryptocurrencies. These are very new. This could be new, or these are maybe not much famous. And Link is, of course, a bit off into the market right now. It also had a 5.92% within the last 24 hours. And now I'm going to see what is the crypto that went down most within the last 24 hours. What I have to do is simply again click this 24 hour. The icon, it is clickable. You can simply click on that. Then you can, it will orderly display what is the crypto that went down in a higher percentage. Likewise, within the last 7 days, if I click 7D, within the last 7 days, 80% increase for ENG coin. That is a very, very significant percentage, right? 80%. Likewise, there are other coins with say 54%, and there are a lot, right? 30%. So these are positive change, and these kinds of coins you have to be very careful, and it's better if you can buy some and keep, because there's a huge increase in percentage compared to the days previously. So that could have a possibility to increase. Likewise, you can see what are the cryptos that are having a negative downward compared to the last 7 days, like the ZK. So you have to avoid investing on cryptos like this. So you will not suffer from investing on a wrong cryptocurrency if you properly analyze this. As I said, if you want to further investigate and identify its trends and patterns, you can still go onto the crypto itself and look into the analysis. So likewise, you can view what has happened. So these are the analysis that gives for the cryptocurrency IOST. There are no data because that is seems to be a newly introduced crypto. Likewise, you can have a very, very clear understanding as to what cryptocurrencies you need to buy based on the patterns or the trends with the demand that these cryptos get. And based on the signals, as I said, signals are the news that you would hear. You can also go to websites like the Blockfolio. You can have a mobile app. So those kinds of the websites will give you the signals, what is happening, how many big companies are trying to influence on the crypto market, and therefore what is the likelihood of increase in price. So that understanding you can clearly have through the signals to this Bitcoin market. I hope now you are clear and as to what crypto that you would like to buy. Of course, BTC, Ethereum, they are the dominant, and there are cryptos like ADA, Polkadot, and also XRP. XRP is considered as more of a payment method where many the companies are implementing and adopting this XRP payment method, and therefore there is more likelihood of having a future demand for this crypto. Just keep in mind, and there can be predictions, good predictions, and good values for these cryptocurrencies. The Chainlink also having the positive figures as of now. So it's all about you investing now. And another interesting coin is the Dogecoin. This became very interesting right after Elon Musk tweeted about this as well, mentioning that he bought some of Dogecoin for his son. And this is also considered to be a meme coin. And since there are some backup and some influence for these cryptos, right now that is a negative, the value is a bit of dropping, and within the last 7 days the value is good, but there can be a good future if there are some influencing people around these cryptocurrencies. So those are also factors that we need to consider when we are selecting what cryptocurrency that we have to invest at the time that you are going to invest. So keep in mind, by the time you visit this and watch this course, and by the time you try to invest on crypto, you have to study the current trends and the practices by that time, and the signals, and study the time that you are trying to invest. Good. All right. So we have covered CoinMarketCap, and now I have say, okay, I'm selecting ADA to buy now, and that is what I have decided from this website. This gives me a lot of information to select what I'm going to buy. Well, now let's go back to Binance and let's do some trading.